Potential. You don't take no extra time on Sunday. Can we talk here? Is God really first in your life? If you go to the people's job and they tell you working on Sunday, that's your schedule, go to work. We're not going to pay you here. We're going to give you the wisdom. But we're not going to pay your bills. But if they call you and say, oh, somebody's out, we need some. No! I know where my skill. I know I got this job. I can't put him aside. I'm just doing this thing because I'm not preaching my message. I'm doing what the Lord I believe. The thing I love about this ministry is it's Holy Spirit led. And if I offend anybody, I pray to God about that. But I'm not going to apologize. Because what's happening is we are ungrateful. We claim that God is doing all these things for us. And the minute he blesses us, we put it aside, Paul.
Yes.
I can tell you we didn't get people out of church. Let me just talk. I need 2 more minutes. A new car, a relationship, and a job. When you make it be a servant diligently to somebody whispering in the air that they no good. Then all of a sudden, I've seen them catch rides for 3 or 4 years. The minute they get a car, they got to clean their car on Sunday night. They work all week. Also pray and believe God with me. But it's a great list. But it's job. They get the job. Now all of a sudden they call me, I gotta go to work. Where is the reverence? Somebody asked me a question this week about the fear of the Lord. And they said, why should I be afraid of God? No, fear does not mean being afraid, it means reverence.
Reverence.
Gentlemen, where is your reverence? I want your peace in my heart. Where is your reverence? At what point do we stop paying? God will give us happy peace. I'm going to come and agree with you. Holy Spirit, I love you. At what point, friend, do we make a choice for God I live? At what point do we invite him into our relationships and into our homes and say, Lord, I'm going to do it your way? I can testify, I don't know what to say much. We survive because we do it his way. There would be no way your prophets and I would be together if we're doing this according to our thinking. It does not match up. But when pressure comes, and you're right, and you want to be right, but you can take yourself away to your prayer closet. I pray. Honestly, about the situation, the Holy Ghost will step in, point out to you where you wrong, and then tell you that you decide what to do. You can leave out of here and cause confusion, or you can leave out of here and be humble.
Amen.
But that's for people. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'll be here. Grab me in his hands. Grab me in his hands. Grab me in his hands. Glory to God. Am I talking to you here? I want you to receive from me what I'm giving you. Listen, stop sitting on the side. Stop being stuck by the side. You kids in school, get your books. Get focused on your work. Stop making excuses. You people who have businesses and jobs, start being the best that you can be. Let the people want to see you come to work. Don't let them dread when you show up.
Amen.
Read your Bible. Of course, in the house, people's job. A price has been paid. Hug the person next to you, please. Just want you to put your trust in Jesus. Tis so sweet to trust in.
Jesus. Just today, give I His word. Just to rest upon His promise of Jesus. Just to know the sin. Jesus, Jesus, I love Him. How I prove Him over. Have you tried it? Jesus, Jesus, pray.